Hello friends, I am DK and I welcome you all in the technical analysis series. Friends, in Zero to Hero, this is the tutorial series session number 34 or episode number 34, and you all know we have been covering step by step Fibonacci sequence, Fibonacci retracements and its relevance. We have learned in the past episode that as to how Fibonacci retracement levels can help us to make a precise entry into the market and help us to design the trading strategy. In today's session, we will be learning Fibonacci expansion tool, which is also called extension tool, which helps us to find out the possible targets. So this will help us. Fibonacci retracement gives us the clue as to how we can design our precise entry in the market. However, Fibonacci expansion tool with other studies, when we combine, can help us to find the targets. So we'll be learning these aspects as to how we can use Fibonacci expansion tool. So friend, if you're watching this video and not yet subscribed the channel, do subscribe so that you are well notified on time for upcoming uploads. And friends, if you are interested to join as a member of this channel, there is a description box below this video where the link is given. You can find out the details of various kind of membership programs that the channel is running in collaboration with YouTube. So friends, let's move ahead and start the today's tutorial under Zero to Hero episode number 34. So friends, let us first conceptually understand that the market, when these particular tools are useful, when the market is trending. If market is in markup phase, which means market will have the wavel formations, will make higher highs and higher lows kind of formation. And when the market is downtrending, it will make lower highs and lower lows kind of formation, which we call it as a markdown phase or redistribution phase. These all aspects we have already learned under tutorial series Zero to Hero. I would always emphasize, friends, that you must develop the very concept of all the six doctrines of Charles Dow, because every principle of technical analysis is guided by all those six doctrines only. Rest are the tools. Once you have the concept behind all the six doctrines of Charles H. Dow, who is considered to be the father of modern day technical analysis, then you will find it much easier to understand various kind of charting tools available to finally analyze the market based on those six doctrines. So let us understand, if market makes a wavel formation, so market doesn't go in a straight line upward, or in a downtrending market, it doesn't come down straight away in a straight line downward, which means market will have various corrections in process of moving upward or moving downward. So the Fibonacci expansion tool is an important tool in any charting software that you use. However, if you use the charting software that I am also using to perform the technical analysis on this channel, there is a link given in the description box of that particular charting tool, which you can access by clicking on the link. So friends, Fibonacci extension tool is a very, very important tool, which is very commonly used by the technical analyst to arrive at the profit targets or to make an estimate as to how far price can go after the correction is over. Say the price is going up because the market is uptrending. So after the price becomes overextended, the price will take a pause and will correct opposite to the direction of prevailing trend, and that forms the corrective wave. So correction takes place against the original trend, and in the direction of the original trend there will be formation of impulsive wave. Because the impulsive wave, why I am calling? Because it's a larger wave in the direction of the original trend, and our intent is to catch that larger wave rather than to venture around the shorter wave, which is a corrective wave. We call it a pullback or retracement. So friends, this helps us to arrive at the targets or to make an estimate how far a price may move after the retracement is over. Extension levels are also possible areas where the price may face some kind of resistance in uptrending market. And in downtrending market, these are the levels where the price may take some kind of reversal from that particular point. So let us understand why these are the targets. Because there is a possibility of reversal, so we are expected to book a profit so that we wait for another upcoming opportunity when the correction will take place, and again we can enter at a value area or value zone in the direction of the trend. So these are the possible areas where the price may reverse, as these acts as supports or resistance depending upon the prevailing trend of the market. And friends, it is very, very important to understand these levels, which are the expansion level or called as extension level, Fibonacci extension level, are nothing but the Fibonacci ratios that we have learned in previous episode under Zero to Hero. But it is expressed in terms of percentage when we apply these tools in market or in price chart. So friends, let us go ahead and understand further about Fibonacci expansion or extension aspects of Fibonacci series. So friends, by now I presume that you might have seen umpteen number of technical analysis that I perform on the price chart, either on a stock market or commodity market or currency market or indices, week on week and during the live streams, that we come 4 live streams in a week. So friends, you might have seen what are the possible levels where we discuss about the targets. However, I just touch upon your memory to tell you about the common levels that Fibonacci expansions are very, very important to understand are 61.8%, 100%, 161.8%, 200%, and 261.8%. However, there is one more level, which is an intervening level, is 127.2% that we commonly use to arrive at the, because we have observed that at 127.2% also the price reverses. So many a times when we get the risk reward ratio properly at 127.2%, we try to book the profit, especially if you are a swing trader. So friends, these are the common levels. Let us understand, since we use Fibonacci expansion tool when the market is in a trending mode, whether it is an uptrending market or a downtrending market, so we find out 3 possible points to draw the Fibonacci expansion by using the tools available in the any standard charting software. And those 3 points can be found only when the market has made certain corrections or has done a pullback or has retraced. A retracement could be a shallow retracement, could be a healthy retracement, or could be a deeper retracement. So we wait till the retracement or correction is over, which is in opposite direction of the prevailing trend. So we require 3 points to draw the lines of these levels by using the expansion tool or Fibonacci extension tool available in any standard charting tool for the purpose. So friends, let us conceptually understand. When the indicator is applied to the chart, the analyst chooses 3 points. And what are those 3 points? If the market is uptrending, there will be formation of an impulsive wave. So the point number one would be the point from where the impulsive wave has started to form. And the point number two would be a point where impulsive wave has ended and the correction has started against the impulsive wave. And then retracement will sometime be halted, maybe at 38.2% or 61.8% or at 50% level or 78.6% that we have covered in Fibonacci retracement tutorial in the last episode. Once that retracement is over, which will be indicated by a formation of a bullish candlestick pattern if the market is in uptrending mode, and a bearish candlestick pattern when the market is in downtrending mode, where the price rejection would be seen. So we get the third point at that particular time. Or many a times, Fibonacci extension tool is also used by two points only. First point is the point from where the impulsive wave has started. Second point where it is ended. A third point is again the point number one overlapping the point number three. When we see the example, I'll tell you the two broader methods which are adopted to use the Fibonacci extension tool to draw the lines on the price chart. So these are the important aspects. Extensions help us in what way? It helps us to approximately know where the price is likely to move. And that is why it helps us to arrive at the possible targets in trending market. So friends, let's understand as to how Fibonacci extension levels help us and what they indicate. However, I have touched briefly. So let us understand that Fibonacci extension levels are possible area of interest for any analyst or a trader, because it gives us two indications. One, it helps us to fix the target, and if that is the target, possibly from where the price is going to reverse, means it is indicating an area which could be possible support or resistance. And friends, it's very, very significant to understand, if the price goes beyond a particular level, it may further move to touch the next higher level in uptrending market, and in a downtrending market, next lower level. So if the price goes past one extension level, it may continue to move towards the next Fibonacci expansion or extension level. And hence, accordingly, we can either trail the stop loss and refix our target in order to ride the trend. So it can help in many ways to understand when we look to towards the example on the chart in this episode of the tutorial. We will let you know as to how it can help us in many ways. Friends, we all know that technical analysis works in any time frame across all asset class. It works in daily time frame, in weekly time frame, in monthly time frame, in hourly time frame, or even in lower time frame like 15 minutes or a half hourly chart. Which means the impulsive wave would be different in different time frames. And hence, it is very, very important to conceptually understand. An impulsive wave, if it is larger in weekly time frame, it will look a little shorter in daily time frame or still shorter in hourly time frame. And hence, it gives us a clue in many ways as to how we can Fibonacci extension can be used for any time frame in any market. It could be used either on any shares, commodities, or any index, or maybe in currency market or currency pairs. And if it can be used across an asset class, ultimately what we are assessing in the technical analysis, we are assessing the human behavior. the psychology behind the market participants, and everywhere the human emotions are involved, whether you are trading in a stock market, commodity market, or currency market, or trading in any indices. So friends, it's very, very important to know, you as a technical analyst may consider one particular as an impulsive wave, where I can a little differ in my observation. Or you are looking at a weekly time frame, I am looking either at a monthly time frame or daily time frame, the size of the impulsive wave would be different in a trending market, which means the Fibonacci expansion or retracement can be drawn with respect to the impulsive wave in different ways. So how it can help? It can help if you draw the Fibonacci retracement or expansion using the tool in different impulsive wave in different time frames, then we can find the clusters of a particular level where the price is behaving in a certain manner, but the price action can be seen and observed on the chart as to how that important cluster is indicating a kind of zones. So finding clusters of Fibonacci levels indicate a price zones that will be significant to find the high probability of areas which can help you to refine your targets or can help you to refine your entry level if you are using the Fibonacci retracement tool. So it helps in decision making when we do the multi-time frame analysis. You might have seen, normally I perform multi-time frame analysis on this channel whenever I do the analysis. You might have seen various videos, over 250-300 videos are available where I have performed analysis on many asset class like stock market, commodity market, currency pair, and index like Nifty, Bank Nifty, Nasdaq, S&P 500, FTSE or ASX. So many technical analysis you might have witnessed, and where multi-time frame analysis helps us to understand the price action better. So friends, broadly we have understood the concept behind Fibonacci retracement in the previous episode, and in this episode we have understood the theoretical aspect as to how Fibonacci extensions can be drawn. I would suggest you and give an emphasis that you must watch all the live streams that we conduct on every Tuesday, every Thursday at 8:30 p.m. and every Sunday at 8 p.m. so that you understand as to how Fibonacci tools are being used to perform the technical analysis, which will develop a concept of the practical aspect of application of these tools on the price chart when the technical analysis is performed. And friends, now let us go straight away. Today I'll be taking two examples. One, when the market is trending up, as to how Fibonacci expansion tools and retracement tool can help us to decide the target and the possible area of supports and resistance. And another example I would take when the market is trending down, so that short selling opportunity when we take, how to calculate the target in those kind of market conditions. So friends, now let us take up the example on the price chart. This is the first example which I am taking on price chart when the market is in uptrending mode. So friends, we can see the market is making higher highs and higher lows kind of formation. So it's a trending market and the trend is up. In this case, we can see this is the formation of impulsive wave, and after this formation, we have allowed the market to correct. So we have got the 3 points. Point number one, from where the impulsive wave started to form, and the prime point number two, from where the impulsive wave has ended, and finally the corrective wave has started, and the finally corrective wave stopped here. So first method what we use is, we select the Fibonacci expansion tool from the side menu bar, and this is the trend based Fib extension. I am selecting it and I am putting the first point here, and then second point here, because the wave ended here, impulsive wave, and I am just dragging down from where the correction has ended. So I have ended here the correction. So in this, automatically the charting software by using this tool has indicated various levels. Now in this particular, our first target in this case is normally 61.8% expansion, and we can see this expansion, as I've explained you in the tutorial, that this is the first target, not because only one aspect, but the market is likely to face a kind of resistance. And you can see the market here after achieving this target has started retracing, and then of course start moving up. And normally if we have a patience to wait for this second correction, then the possible target could be 100% expansion as well. However, those who are a swing trader will try to book the profit here, because they have made an entry somewhere something around 149.50 rupees when trading was taking place, and the target of 188 was fairly a good target to book a profit in this uptrending stock. And then they wait for this another correction to complete to calculate another target, which I am again drawing, considering this as an impulsive wave and this as a retracement. So the impulsive wave started here, it ended here, and then I am drawing this. So we can see here 61.8% got achieved. In this case, the rejection started at what level? At 100% level, 209, and we can see again the correction takes place. So in uptrending market, the wavel formation, higher highs and higher lows kind of formation is a regular phenomenon, which gives us several opportunity to trade on long side. Another method I am reviewing this drawing, another method I am going to explain, which is also popular and many analysts use this. So I am using the same tool, Fibonacci expansion, putting this as a first point, second point where the wave has ended, impulsive wave, and again I am dragging back to the first point, which is becoming now the first point gets overlapped with third point. And we can see that in this particular case, our first target expected goal is 127.2% expansion, and we can see exactly from here the retracement has started taking place. So the price was facing resistance at this particular point. Similarly, on another, of course, the price may go up to 161.8% retracement level. Ultimately, that target has been achieved. So I am using once again the same tool, and considering this as an impulsive wave. So I am using this as an impulsive wave, and I am using the correction to take place, and we can see exactly at 127.2% with respect to this impulsive wave and this corrective wave. If you can see, it has got rejection. And another method, I take this and then draw back this swap at point number one, and we can see 127.2%, which is at around 204, the price got rejection and retracement took place. So whichever manner you want to use, but if you see in our channel where we perform the majority of the analysis, what I do is I select the tool, and majority of the time I personally use is by using the trend-based wave extension. I use this as the first point, second point is this, and third point again back to point number one, which point number three will overlap point number one. And in this method, my first expected goal would be 127.2%, second would be 168.1%. Yes, retracement has taken place. Now once this target is achieved, my stop loss would be shifting here, was here previous swing low, and then wait for a bigger goal. Ultimately, price has gone past. As we have explained in the tutorial, when the price breaches one level, here the price has broken this level. So next level was achieved. Here the price with the gap up broken this level. So even 200% was achieved. So riding the trend is a very important aspect in trading stock. Now let us go to another example where we will take up a stock which is downtrending and as to how we can use Fibonacci expansion tool to arrive at the target when we short sell a particular stock. This is the price chart of Lupin in daily time frame on NSE India. It is a downtrending stock. We can see all the moving averages are indicating that it is an established downtrend. What we can see, we can take a reference of this as an impulsive wave downside, because in this downtrending stock, impulsive wave would be forming when the stock is falling. And this is the retracement, which is a corrective wave. So in the similar manner, the method would be the exactly same but in opposite direction. Here I am selecting the trend based Fib extension tool. I am selecting as a point number 1. In the first method, I take it to this point and then drag it here to the third point, which is where the correction has ended, because this is the corrective wave in case of a downtrending market. Our first, we could have short sell here at something around 935. And our first target on downside would have been 800, which is 61.8%. We can see here the price has achieved the target and then a small support was taken and a small impulsive wave was formed, and finally price has achieved the 100% level as well. Now another method which I have explained you can be used here. I am taking this as a third point to back to this level. So point number 1, this point number 2, this again point number 3, overlapping point number 1, and here the first target would be 127.2%. we can see the target has been achieved and then upside correction has started. So similarly, we can select another impulsive wave. This is yet another impulsive wave, so I am using it, taking us to the correction, then taking it back, and we can see 127.2%. We could have sold here at around 817 and the target was 733 as per the Fibonacci expansion tool at 127.2%. This is how we can build upon the trading strategy, and we book a profit in a swing trading especially simply because that is expected to be an area of interest where the possible buying can come back when we are short selling. So there is the maximum point we book the target and wait for another wave formation to give patiently, to give a patient waiting for upcoming opportunity. So friends, if you have liked this tutorial and presentation, please give a thumbs up to this video, give a like, click on the like button, so that friends, it motivates me. I would be expecting your comments in the comment section of this video so that I can also have an feedback for further improvement. And friends, do share this video among your social base, friend circle, trader community, WhatsApp group, so that other people also receive benefit out of these kind of tutorials, and in the process they subscribe the channel to become part of your and my family. Friends, thank you very much for watching. Looking forward to meet you again. Thank you very much.